Growing up, I had a very refined palate. Marge Sr. loved to feed me the breakfast of champions, coffee and Oreos. When I started kindergarten, I was especially proud to share this information. All the kids sat in a circle, and everybody went around to say what they'd had for breakfast that day. One little girl had enjoyed pancakes. How basic. Others had indulged in eggs and bacon. But as soon as our teacher, Miss Dietrich, came to me and said, "Margaret, what did you have?" I proudly announced my glamorous breakfast of coffee and Oreos. Immediately, I saw the horror on her face. She said, "Coffee and Oreo cookies? Well, that's not very healthy." Of course, I was totally mortified, until she got to Rudolph, who admitted he'd eaten hot dogs, which was much worse in her opinion. So I felt better about myself. Thanks, Rudolph. But you know, coffee kept me nice and perky. I mean, maybe that's why nap time really didn't work for me. I always loved my dose of caffeine. Then I went home and told Marge Sr., and she was like, "It's not a big deal. We're very European." That was always her answer to everything. We're European. European kids always drink coffee. I told my mother that I felt really badly that Miss Dietrich was upset. She could see I was distressed. So for Christmas, Marge Sr. bought her the most expensive perfume, which at the time was Estee Lauder Youth Dew. The Oreos became a non-issue. If there was one thing my mother taught me very early in life, it was the art of the bribe. She knew that beautiful gifts put people in the right frame of mind, mainly when she'd buck something up. I would say I'm the same way. I like to give beautiful gifts, but not because I fucked up. It's the old, you can catch more flies with honey trick, and it works